All right, here's some historically accurate riveted mail that one of my viewers kindly made for me for testing. And, this is it's not the greatest setup here, but hopefully it'll be okay. Here's some minor damage from a previous test that I never uploaded because I wasn't happy with it. But that's pretty much all, I think. Yeah, that's really the only thing. So I have to keep that in mind. This blade, I really don't expect to go through, but we shall see. We need some weight on there. Now for a little more oomph. Nope, did not go through. It was stuck in one of the rings. Well, it snuck in between the rings, but it didn't break them. So, yeah, stabbed a little bit into the cloth underneath, but not much. Yeah, again, gets through just a little bit. Okay, so this is all we got. So with enough padding underneath, this would do absolutely nothing. This should have a better chance. All that taper in the blade. That went very high. And yeah, we do have some penetration. That was not great, but it did the job. That is fairly decent. Not really deep enough to do sufficient damage. Like, wouldn't be lethal, but it would certainly be an injury. Can see it went through a ring. In fact, I can just take that out here and show you. There it is. Yeah, that's what this kind of blade shape is for. That's exactly what it's for, and it works. Okay, just to prove that you can also do this without gloves, it's more comfortable with, but it works. Yeah, I even saw a ring or a piece of a ring fly. So yeah, this was pretty decent. And we've got the hole in the mail. So yeah, a powerful spear thrust can certainly deal with it. Even though I hit right under the previous hole, it still did some extra damage. You can see how it spread open that ring there. No wonder they used rondel daggers to stab through the gaps in plate where they wore mail. It does the job quite nicely. Also gets stuck like crazy though, at least this kind of triangular cross section.